it was. And here, you can go any part of the venue. You can go through the arena. You can go to Jubilee Land, and you're not crowded. You're not stuck with, you know, everyone just cramped
in. There's so much space.
And there's so many setups.
So
many setups. It's fantastic. Like, we are blowing through bracket right now.
Oh man.
This is going to be great.
So we see La Luna
and the moon.
Decked out in the all purple too, looking clean today. I gotta see his hands. I gotta know if he's got the purple controller with it, because really, that's how you finish a bracket. Oh, and the streamrunner gets us with looking great. Let's see a Mark Ditto. What do you think?
Oh yeah, definitely gonna see chain grabs.
Yeah, man. Baby.
You wanna get the tech chase and chain grabs? You know, mostly tech chase grabs.
Of course, like,
that's what you want. You want to be fishing out, you know. Whoever's gonna be the first Mark to get off stage, man. That's what that Mark player wants, man. Control stage, you know. So if you guys didn't know, if you look at the entries from this year, 440 entries, and then you do a comparison with the entries from last year, it's absolutely insane. It's actually doubled. I was doing some research about that not too long ago. And it's insane. I was just talking about, like, the entries for this year's Melee Bracket in CEO.
I mean,
so many people this year than last year.
It's really unfortunate that Leffen has decided to focus on DBFC. I was really looking forward to seeing him play Melee and Fighters this weekend, but deciding to focus on the Fighters Bracket and improving in that. Best of luck to him in that. Instead, we have La Luna and Saint Shaden starting down on Dreamland.
Already
big
off the
start.
Bat, man. He's doing such a great job taking him off the stage, but okay.
I like the turns of fortune we're seeing here so far. Both Martins getting in that initial grab, knowing how important that is. La Luna getting that extra combo damage too. So good.
Yeah, way too far from that. So he's taking that first stock at ease. That's what he's looking for. He's looking for a nice grab. Once he gets that grab, you'll see the amount of damage he's going to collect just off of one grab. Okay. Shading, you know, trying to do the same thing as the moon was doing to him. Okay.
Yeah, definitely seeing anytime you see a Ditto, it's going to be everything you can do, I can do better.
Yeah.
But it's going to be really, really tough against a Mark in the league that is La Luna. It's so, like, you want to be able to say, I'm going to be able to beat you at your own game. And it's so hard to do against a player of this caliber. Here we go. I like the F smash. I like him continuing to guard that ledge. There should be that stock there.
There we go. Nice. Or even a Marv killer would be fine. Marv
sure.
Killer on Marv.
Only fitting.
Marv using the Marv killer on Marv. That's somehow ironic. Ooh, nice place Tibber there.
Yeah, just that slight walk forward. Oh, but now we're seeing La Luna starting to move around a little bit.
It's definitely a pitchfork fight. Who's going to get the first pitchfork hit? Yeah, I like that. The moon actually mixing it up there on ledge. You see how he's like holding shield and light shield, try to position himself just in case. Shaden's gonna change his recovery option.
Big damage from these up tilts.
Definitely could have gotten more out of that.
Yeah, it's a tough break there. La Luna taking the risk of expending that double jump, but it works out for him. He's able to counter hit and get out of those combo strings. Reads the neutral get up with the up B. Dang.
Yeah, position himself for a nice hard tipper there. Moon a step ahead, of course.
Beautiful roll for getting that extra grab, getting that forward smash. It's really just been raw pressure from La Luna.
You can definitely see the skill gap with these two players, man. It's insane.
Oh, beautiful option coverage there. Oh, now the hyper aggressive
so
option
deep,
with a fair.
Oh, yeah. Might as well since Moon is up two stocks, yeah.
For sure.
Okay, but actually, makes it back on stage. Oh, but he hits him with the tipper.
Oh, just comes down with a neutral beam. Luna trying to put a little bit of an exclamation point on the end of this game. You notice after you got that F smash, there's no more offstage shenanigans. It's like, all right, I'm just gonna take care of this.
Good option. By the way, good option for Moon. Whenever he's doing side B, it's gonna pop up that character upward. So giving him another option to hit him with. And like around that percentage, like, man, it's gonna send him flying.
I was just about to mention that. The fact that he was using that as a mix-up tool and seeing how he was able to cover the options afterwards, such a great option for him. See what Sate Janin can try to do to kind of counteract the aggressiveness with him and Laluna. It's just been, when you have a character that excels at spacing the way Marth does, and you have someone that has such great spacing that Laluna does, it makes it so difficult to try to counterplay that. Because now you have to think a step further. How am I going to outspace the person that is outspacing me?
Exactly. You also have to be really patient in this matchup when it comes to, like, who's getting the first grab. Yeah. Like, if you're too antsy, you're going to miss, and then you're just going to give that opponent opportunity to grab you right back.
Absolutely. And we've seen a lot of different interactions on how these players are getting that initial grab, too. Whether it's the down tilt grab, whether it's the spot dodge of someone else's grab.
That was sick. He went so far for that. He actually lands the Dolphin Slash on him.
And we saw him going for that game one, not working out, but getting a game two now.
Actually gets in there. Good stuff. Shaden, honestly, like, not doing a bad job. Like, he's not.
Absolutely not.
He hasn't gotten four-star or anything like that.
This is not a showing that to be ashamed of by any stretch of the imagination. And the best part about moments like this, playing mirrors and pools, is you get someone's attention. You're playing someone at the caliber of Laluna. You can come up to players like, hey, let's work on this some more. Show me what I should be doing in this matchup, which is such an important thing for the learning process.
Some more crouch cancel from Shaden there. Try to catch him on top platform. Okay.
And that's just that step ahead.
Stuffing him. Moon is just stuffing him right now.
And he saw that Shaden was going to go for that shield drop aerial. Wave dashes away from the platform and just puts him in a bad
situation. He's going so low. I mean, might as well, right?
He's going to be so sick if it landed, though. But Shaden's saying, you're not going to get these extra hits on me. You're not going to style on me. This is not going on some clip reel somewhere.
This is there. Okay.
Just follows up behind him.
Yep.
F smash to the back, and Laluna